Believe it or not, we are now 10 days into the grand tour around Europe. We have been very busy, and we are now on our third full day here in Aptera, Crete, where we're getting some downtime and chance to explore a single region. Yesterday, we drove down to the southern coast to the Libyan Sea, where we went to the town of Paleohora and hung out on mostly on the west side beach, the Sunset Beach, which is by far the larger and more popular of the two. Did some exploring of the town, drove all the way across the island, which Crete is a giant mountain range coming out of the Mediterranean. And these mountains are extremely high, and there are very few passes that actually go from the north side of the island to the south side of the island. So it takes about an hour to drive from the north shore to the south shore at one of the narrower points, and it is a lot of winding mountainous roads. So not for the faint of heart. I mean, it's pretty decently easy drive, but Dominica and the girls have a bit of motion sickness, and so the drive is kind of hard for them even as the non-driver. But remember, if you're driving in Crete, you're always driving a standard. It is stick shift everywhere, which for people who are used to it, no big deal. But if you're not, mountain driving with a stick shift can be just a bit harrowing. Let me tell you, the Libyan Sea was beautiful. The water was crystal clear. You could see the bottom. You could see little tiny fish, even when you're pretty deep, see little fish down along the bottom, but tiny fish, nothing that you would worry about. The bottom was almost entirely just slightly rippled sand, very smooth. It goes out a long way. You can just wade in, and you know, you go out a couple feet and you just go down an inch or two. So very comfortable for you know, just kind of getting in the water and relaxing. Good for kids and families because, you know, there's no riptides, there's no big surf, nothing like that. The sunsets over Paleohora, absolutely amazing. And we have to say, the most gorgeous, all of us agreed, the most gorgeous moonrise we had ever seen. Full moon, total reflection across the Libyan Sea as it came up last night. Just mind-blowingly beautiful. And the village of Paleohora, oh, just great. It was beautiful. It's one of those perfect seaside villages. It has enough tourists that has everything you want, enough hotels, Airbnbs, rooms for let, lots and lots of cafes and shops. The beaches are loaded with local restaurants that just have, you know, chairs out, and you can rent the chairs or buy food and sit out on the chairs and that kind of stuff. Really comfortable, easy to deal with. Not super expensive, but not so many tourists that it feels like a tourist trap. It's not like Santorini and Fira, where you're like, this is just you know, mobs of tourists. There's no locals. It's all fake. Paleohora doesn't give that feel. You can tell that locals still live there. It still has its own complete feel. The look and feel of the houses, totally different than the North Shore and other villages we've been to here in Crete. So really highly recommended. A bit of a drive, but absolutely gorgeous. Go there. I would totally spend a night doing it again, maybe two nights, and explore some of the restaurants, enjoy different beaches. There is a museum on the island. There is shopping on the peninsula. There's shopping. There's an archaeological fortress at the top, and there is a small port with tiny ferries that go to some of the other small villages around the area. So it could be a launching point to several other beaches and villages to explore that are decently remote. And we didn't do that, but I guarantee those other villages don't have nearly as many tourists as Paleohora. You're going to get more and more authentic as you go out. And the drive, at least coming from here in Aptera, which is the same drive that you would do coming from places like Ceuta and Hanya, goes, it's pretty seriously through the mountains, but the views are spectacular. It gives you a whole different look to Crete than you get it doing anything else. Those central mountains are absolutely gorgeous with olive groves and winding paths and little tiny communities. It looks so much more like Andalusia than you picture Crete normally looking like. Very, very cool. And between here and there on that, you know, hour-long north-south drive, there were, you know, three or four really cool-looking villages that I wish we had time to stop and explore. If nothing else, just stopping and getting some lunch or dinner or some crepes for dessert or something. Just gorgeous and very lively late at night. So we were very surprised to find that. It looked like a really interesting area. So yesterday was a huge, successful beach day for us.